Contentment is a rare state of mind that even the wisest among us sometimes find strenuous to attain. There is no end to what the heart can desire, and because we can never have all that we want, we will always be unhappy. If we can't satisfy with what we have, the way to happiness is to learn how to restrain our human desires, especially the desire to have more. Disappointment comes when we can't obtain what we desire or expect. We foolishly ignore our loved ones to obtain what we desire, only to find the joy it brings is only temporal. Someone once said that the constant preoccupied with self and selfish desire is a sure road to misery. Avoid self-pity. Recognize that everyone, even pop stars and millionaires, have problems. Accept your situation and take small steps to improve it. Helping others in little ways bring unexpected happiness. It takes your focus away from the poor me syndrome. Appreciate and treasure what you have now. You can never tell what will happen tomorrow. You may lose that special friend or loved one whom you've been taking for granted. A wise man once said, "Seek not wealth or riches, instead seek to be wise." Contentment is natural wealth, but luxury is artificial poverty. It's better to be happy with the codfish in your plate now than to linger for a taste of tuna that is still swimming in the sea. For you will never know what is enough unless you know what is more than enough. For a meaningful life is not being rich, being popular, being highly educated, or being perfected in the wisdom of this world. It is about being real, being humble, being able to share ourselves and touch the life of others. It is only then we would have a full, happy, and contented life. For life isn't about finding yourself. Life is about Christ finding you and creating a new purpose in you. For we tend to forget that true happiness comes from a life in Christ, and that it doesn't come as a result of getting something we don't have, but rather of recognizing and appreciating what we have to do. For he who is not contented with what he has would not be contented with what he would like to have. So my friends, there is no austerity equal to a balanced mind, and there is no happiness equal to contentment. There is no disease like covetousness, no virtue like mercy. The secret of contentment is knowing how to enjoy what you have and to be able to lose all desire for things beyond your reach that will push you away from God. For health is the greatest gift, contentment is the greatest wealth, faithfulness is the best relationship. The simple things in life have the capacity to bring us to the greatest joy, if only we take a moment to recognize them. For happiness will never come to those who fail to appreciate what they already have. Gratitude is the key to happiness and abundance in your life. Focus on what you have and you will find you will attract more of it. Peace comes from within, so do not seek it without. Peace and contentment are inner states of being. They do not come from people, places, or things, but from God. Not that I speak in respect of want, for I have learned in whatsoever state I am therewith to be content. But godliness with contentment is great gain, for we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. And having food and raiment, let us be therewith content. But they that will be rich fall in temptation and snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. Yes, the richest man is not he who has the most, but he who needs the least, because with Jesus he have everything. This is true contentment. Little is much when God is in it, my friends.